Just a great picture sitting here with someone and you the same technique to hold your racket. Apply one edge of your racket to point to the court that you hold your racket vertical. Wrap your finger around for your racket, tip at the back end. Place your wrist against the handle, lay your palm and behind the handle of the racket. If your right hand is players, grip the racket that the right side of your body and tip it with your wrist that the back of the handle slightly to the right. The space between your index finger and thumbs should be just that the bottom of the rear of the handle. This is the most. Keep your racket down to the left of your body. If your left hand is players, grip the racket with your palm. Grip the racket with your palm slightly behind the handle. Keep the grip at the left mid end of the handle. The space between your index finger and thumb should be sure at the rear than the above the handle. This is the most common dip for beginner. Now that's the eastern forehand dip. It is to his short left forehand because it is the most natural and versatile wrist. However, there are also a western and continental wrist view for all the techniques. Short slice the slice. Close the racket face when using the eastern forehand dip. When you hit with power, close the racket face on your backswing, closing the racket face in your backswing, generate more toss spins. When you hit the ball with power, aim slightly higher in the top of the net. Use the semi-western grip to hit with speed and spins. Place the knuckle of your index finger and lower palm on the floor, apple the racket grip. Also, practice to play the racket flat on the ground. When you begin up, you hit the natural contact point between your shoulders and waist. Choose your back swing so that this close by angling the visible racket just the ground. You can hit the ball harder as you close your back swing more. Practice making the ball go airborne as you apply more power. Brand quick eat more speed. If that is correctly, you will naturally the power of your forehand. Quick eat he the small spins with the western forehand dip. Place the knuckle of your index finger and the bottom of the palm. Mount the fifth pebble of the racket dip. Sucker please to place the racket flat on the ground. When you pick it up, you create the natural contact point between your shoulders and waist. Don't. Rip the racket to tightly. You want to easily tip the rip to quickly the appropriate type of source. For example, you may change to a continental wrist from an eastern wrist to hit the chop source or short slice. Choose your wrist. A western wrist can generate the most spin. For the western wrist, place the knuckle of your index finger and the bottom of the palm of your hand on the fifth pebble of the racket grip. It can take you a long time to learn top spins, technique, stutter, and coach Peter Ryle says. If there's movement in your wrist, once you learn the basics of technique, top spins can add power to your shoulder. However, top spins is more advanced and mastering than this movement takes a long time. It's not going to happen overnight. that danger the correct stance have a semi open stand in lest the opponent hit the ball short. If the ball leaves his short step forward, danger neutral stance for the semi open stand. Take a slight step to the side and rotate your shoulder until you lock your hit at the pelvic joint. The rock position maintains balance by lifting your non-hitting hand parallel to the coat. Relax your dominant hand bend and relax your hand as you hold your racket vertical. Wrap your fingers around for your racket, tip at the butt end. Place your wrist against the handle. Lay your palm barely behind the handle of the racket. If your right hand is placed on the racket, tap the right. Relax your dominant hand bend and relax your hand that you hold your racket vertically. Keep the bucket facing the coat and your body just. Relax your dominant hand bend and relax your hand that you hold your racket vertically. Keep the bucket facing the coat and your body just. But bend at your knees, rotate your body as your bend, please complete your full body rotation. Body rotation. Initiate your screen, push out your dominant neck, then left and rotate your shoulder and hip. Keep your weight on your dominant neck and bend your knees. Your dominant foot should be pointed downward when you stand in the lock position. Keep your shoulder perpendicular to the next leg. Keep your shoulder perpendicular to the next leg. Keep your shoulder perpendicular to the next that you watch the ball. Lower your non-dominant shoulder. Keep your dominant hand holding the racket vertical and your non-dominant arm parallel to the coat. Parallel to the coat. Create a C shape with your screen. Start to chop like you create a C shape screen space to the ball. Unfold your shoulder then push up your dominant leg. Open up your shoulder and hip to the further chop your racket. Watch the ball last you chop your racket. Strike the ball square your body to keeping the racket below the ball. Rotate your body forward and bring the racket face to the ball. Cock your dominant wrist to completely back at your clap to the ball. Straighten up your dominant neck. As you push up to your hip, your dominant neck will begin to slightly dip up the ground. Keep your head steady and keep your head steady. Keep your dominant neck will begin to slightly dip up the ground. Keep your head steady and watch the ball left on new path. Follow through, keep your body stretch that your non-dominant foot reach the ground. Extend your dominant hand to the contact. Finish your swing across your body rather than across your shoulder. Keep your eye on the ball, lower your dominant shoulder. Your dominant foot will come forward to keep your balance. Keep your eye on the ball over your dominant shoulder. Your dominant foot will land back on the ground and your non-dominant hand should catch the racket that you follow through. Your dominant foot will come forward to keep your balance that your body fully protects to complete the hit. Practice as much as possible, perfect your forehand through repetitions. Try to mimic the same motion over and over again. When you want to create a hard burst by using your shoulder, that's when it can pressure upper game. Your muscle will be able to execute the same movement. Visualize your correct stroke, keep things simple and don't confuse yourself with too much info. With too much information, visualize your correct stroke, keep things simple and don't confuse yourself. With too much information, visualize your smooth stroke path. You can only improve your forehand through repetitions. Visualization can help your body keep the correct movement. That maximize the accuracy, top speed, and power of your forehand. Simplify your strokes. Don't try to copy the idiosyncrasies to the top rows. Master the fundamental first. And then an easy and simple swing that feels natural to you. Power and top spins will come on. They don't trying to change the basics. Focus on your footwork. You must move your feet in such perfect timing and movement to keep your idea balance set up correctly. To receive the ball, setting up in time will give you options where to hit the ball. The correct setup be having your non-dominant left and then your knees, your dominant foot. Focus on focus, you must move your feet in such perfect timing and movement to keep your idea balance set up correctly to receive the ball. Setting up in time will give you option where to hit the ball. The correct setup be having your non-dominant left in front of the outer wall ball near your bend. Your hips and shoulders should be open. Let your body ready to explode into your forehand. So let the right shot use the forehand as the weapon. Then strategically hit your shot. Nên strategically hit your shot. So let the right shot use the forehand as your weapon. Nên strategically hit your shot. That optimum location. Be patient and vary the location and speed of your shot. Keep your opponent guessing. For example, if your opponent is directly in front of you, you may want to hit your forehand across the court so that the opponent must learn to receive it. When someone is forced to learn to make a shot, it increases the level of difficulty. As he must aim and generate ball of balance. So let the resource you the forehead as a weapon and strategically hit yourself that optimum location. Be patient and vary the location and speed of your shot. Keep your opponent guessing. For example, if your opponent is directly in front of you, you may want to hit your forehead across the coast so that the opponent must run to the deep beat. When someone is forced to run to make a shot, it increases the level of difficulty as he must aim and generate warlock balance. The right shot is loading the opponent with nerve. For example, if the opponent has the wish backhand aim to explode it. Position yourself correctly. Don't hit the ball when it's too close or too fast from the body. Avoid hitting the ball in a sideways direction or refuse in front of you. Don't hit the ball. Let the comfortable wrist when it's close to your hip. Avoid hitting the ball with a close racket face. Open your racket face that you make contact. Create a rushing effect between your racket and the ball to create a top spin. Make sure that the angle of your swing moves from low to high. Make sure you sample your weight and follow through for top spin. Follow through over your dominant shoulders. Chamfer your weight in a forward and upward direction. And bend your knees, change your repetition, and straightening them as you inhale and rotate your body to hit the ball. Use the right wrist for the right foot if the foot produces a low bow to your boss, then the semi-western wrist. Use the right wrist for the right foot if the coach produces a low bounce to your bound, then the western or semi-western dip is that there. This will allow you to hit the ball. Like the comfortable wrist. If the coach produces a low bounce to your bound, then the semi-western dip is that there. The eastern dip is that there. So his flat dance just short. Even if you play a wall top by the same code, they will still load the different screen. Don't be disappointed if there are differences in your screen. Display a different, even if you play a wall top by the same code, they will still load the different screen. Don't be disappointed if there are differences in your screen. Relative to your display a different, even if you play a wall top by the same code, they will still load the different screen. Don't be disappointed if there are differences in your screen. Relative to your favorite player, the mechanic and the yo, the what's most important.